This is what I hate. You spend hours building an awesome battery-powered project and it dies in a couple of hours. It's useless. But what if I told you that with a few simple lines of code, we can make an ESP32 project last for weeks or months or maybe even years on a single battery? I'm going to show you the secret to slashing ESP32's power usage by over 99%. This is not a joke. Stay with me. Real quick, if you get any value from this video, a simple click of the like and subscribe button would mean the world to me. I'm just a person in my workshop trying to make cool stuff and share it with you. Your support genuinely makes it possible for me to keep doing this. And I promise you, I read every single comment. Your feedback will directly shape what I do on this channel next. Thank you. Seriously. All right, enough talk. Let's make your batteries last forever. So what's the big problem? Your ESP32 is powerful. It's got a dual core brain, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. It's basically a tiny computer. And when it's just sitting there, fully awake, it's like leaving your gaming PC on 24/7. It is chugging power. Look at this, 20 milliamps. That's our battery killer right there. But we're about to introduce it to its worst nightmare. It's called deep sleep mode. And it's the ultimate ESP32 battery saver. In deep sleep, the ESP32 turns off almost everything. The main brain, the Wi-Fi, the Bluetooth, all off. It's basically in a coma. But it leaves one tiny part of its brain awake, the real-time clock, or RTC. This little guy keeps track of time and, more importantly, it can act like an alarm clock to wake the whole system up. This is perfect for projects that only need to do something every few minutes or once a day, like a weather station, a plant watering system, or a security sensor. It's a total game changer. So how do we wake it up from this coma? There are a few ways, but today we're focusing on the best of them all for scheduled tasks. The timer, wake up. We can literally tell the ESP32, hey, go to sleep, and I want you to wake up in exactly 5 seconds, or 5 minutes, or 5 hours. But here's the important part you have to know. When it wakes up, it doesn't remember anything. It's like a full reboot. The code starts all over again from the setup function. So how do we know if our project is working or just stuck in a boot loop? I'm about to show you the one piece of code that solves this. All right, let's build this thing. It is so simple. You need an ESP32. I'm using a C3 model, a battery, a multimeter to see the magic, and an LED. That's it. Now for the code. Don't be scared. We're going to walk through the most important parts. Okay, the first bit of magic is right here. RTC data ATTR. This looks fancy, but all it means is, hey, ESP32, save this boot count variable in that special RTC memory that stays on during deep sleep. This is our secret weapon. This is how our ESP32 can remember how many times it has woken up. Next, in our setup function, we tell it how to wake up. This line, ESP, sleep, enable, timer, wake up, is us setting the alarm clock. We've set it to 5 seconds for this test. Now, the loop is where the action happens. First, we blink the LED. This is our visual proof that the ESP32 is awake and doing stuff. And then, the final command. The two words that make all this possible. ESP, deep sleep, start. That's it. When the code hits this line, the ESP32 says goodnight and goes into its power-saving coma until the timer we set earlier wakes it back up. Before that though, super important tip. See this serial flush? If you're printing messages to your computer to debug, you need this line. It makes the ESP32 wait to make sure all the messages are sent before it goes to sleep. Don't forget it. All right, the moment of truth. The code is uploaded, the battery is plugged in. Are you ready to see something incredible? Okay, it's awake. Boot number one. Now look at the multimeter. There it is, around 20 milliamps. In this mode, our battery is going to last hours, maybe a day. It's been about 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go to sleep. Look at that. That's not 30 milliamps, that's 30 microamps. We just cut power consumption by over 99%. And look, the boot count is going up. It is waking up, doing its job, and going right back to sleep. This is the key. This is how you make a project that runs for months. But what if you want to go even further? What if you want to go for a year? Tip 1. Choose the right board. Some development boards have extra components that waste power. Look for boards designed for low power. Tip 2. Manually turn off what you're not using. If you don't need Bluetooth, turn it off completely before you sleep. Tip 3. Dynamic frequency scaling. You can actually slow down the ESP32's CPU when it's awake to save even more power. So there you have it. We took a project that would die in a day and gave it the superpower to last for an incredibly long time. Deep sleep isn't just a feature, it's the key to unlocking truly portable, long-life ESP32 projects. We learned what deep sleep is, we walked through the code, we saw the proof on the multimeter, and we looked at some optimizations to take this further. Now, it's your turn. I'm putting a link to the full code in the description below. Take it, use it, and build something amazing with it. And I want to know what you're going to build. A birdhouse that tweets? A mailbox notifier? A secret agent gadget? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for hanging out with me. Now go make something awesome.